Nature Center. Thank you so much, Chuck, for bringing in all the shows, the snowshoes. And let's take a look at what kind of personality we can find in St. Joe and Benton Harbor, Michigan.
Oh, over and over, I tried to prove my love to you. Over and over.
Russia has the Hermitage, England has the Octagon, and South Bend, St. Joe, Benton Harbor, Michigan area, northern Indiana, and southwestern Michigan has a hologram maker. Joining us in the studio this afternoon on WNIT Open Studio is Jesus Lopez. And Jesus, cool stuff. What is all that that we saw on that videotape?
This is that. What's his name? He bring the dog.
Kelsey bring a dog
and make a hologram we call single reflection beam.
Single reflection beam.
So that traces an object like this positive.
Yes.
And we set on top of it the holographic plate.
Okay, what you have here is like a piece of glass on the bottom, and then you have some sort of...
It's a second version.
It's a what?
The second version.
A second version. And then on top of it is some sort of a clay material. What's that?
The first answer.
Okay, the first sensor.
In the video, what we have is a solid piece, the little dog, we use as a model. On top of it, we set the plate with the recording material on one side. And we will use this one like I was the laser beam. And we hit with the laser beam and process it.
That's complicated, actually. I'm speechless.
No, it's very easy. 2 minutes.
2 minutes. Okay,
and
go
after
ahead.
After that, you have the hologram inside the plate. In this case is what we are doing with kids at the studios. They make
the
Richard Hunt Studio Center.
Oh, good. Okay.
And in Benton Harbor, so make the piece with plastiline.
Yeah, and that sort of like looks like a person's face.
Yes. What is the one?
The camera.
The four?
Yeah, he'll get you.
Okay. See it. So anyway, from this piece, we make a plaster mold and have a negative form.
Yeah.
And from that negative form, that's the tricky part, we set up the plate.
Okay.
Hit with the laser.
Yes.
Process it. And when it's done, we display in opposite direction. And that way,
a hologram.
You see the piece just floating at the space.
Yes. Yeah. Now you have one here, right? Is that what this is? But you can't see it because of
it's
the light.
It's a diffuse light. It's a good light, but it's diffuse. We need with no filter.
Yeah, right. Perfect. We have diffusers on us, but that's what it actually looks like. How long have you been making these?
7 years.
7 years. What got you started in it?
I started by reading.
Reading? Yeah.
And after that, I moved to the United States to get in the Art Institute. And learn a little bit about the technique. And
which art institute in the U.S.?
Chicago.
In Chicago?
The Art Institute of Chicago.
And now you live in Benton Harbor.
Yes.
What do you like about Benton Harbor?
It's a wonderful city. I have a lake. I have everything. I walk in distance. People is friendly. And
I great
like
place.
The snow.
You love the snow, really? That's cool. Great place for an artist, isn't it?
Well, in Mexico City, we don't have snow.
So you were born and raised in Mexico City.
Yes.
Yeah. Now, what do you show, or where do you show your holograms?
Very much in museums and public galleries.
Okay.
Actually, is one in this, what is the name of this university?
Indiana University South Bend. You have a showing right there right now. So if people want to check out your work, they would go to IUSB.
Actually, I need the input from